Yo, ladies and gentlemen, I'm MC Zenman, and welcome to Space Engineers. So this is going to be my little, mod showcase, my weekly mod showcase, my mod roundup, weekly roundup, Space Engineers roundup, whatever I decide to call it. And this is going to be where every week I take the top three ships and the top three mods from Space Engineers, and I put them together in one big orgy of awesomeness for you guys to check out and enjoy. This is the first Space Engineers I've ever recorded, so if I seem a little bit noobish, then blame it on that. But anyway, yeah. The reason I've waited so long to start with Space Engineers is because, well, I had to get my computer upgraded quite a bit first. So, that's another video. But, yeah, so, first ever weekly roundup. And as I've said, I've got three ships and three mods for you guys to check out. This week we've got two fighters and a big ship, that beaut over there. That is the Ciri by AlexanderUA. Now, I've got 5 minutes to review all of these guys. So, I've got my phone set for 5 minutes. So I've got 5 minutes to review this, then 5 minutes to review these two guys, and then 5 minutes to review the other mods, and we'll see how I get on, because I don't want this to be too long of a video. So yes, the Ciri by AlexanderUA, freaking gorgeous ship, as you can see right here, right now. Yeah, absolutely, I freaking love the way this ship looks. So notes, the mass is 14.38 kilotons, got 64 gyroscopes, reactors, and batteries, 706 megawatts. Now, I do want to point out before we get into the ship that this thing comes with a crap ton of mods. So when you first load this thing up, you're probably going to be experiencing load times of a minute or more as the game downloads all the mods. 28 mods, in fact. Armor thrusters, I'm listing them all right now. Armor thrusters, docking ring, AI core, dead tech, missile hall pack, bunk bed, SSI, regent and table, dead tech catwalk pack, simple work desk. Sage, you know what? I'm going to put all of those up in a little bit of on-screen text. Boom, there you go. So you can check all those out yourself. I'm just going to get right to reviewing the ship itself. So yeah, I've been in here before. I took a little brief tour. There's some pictures actually that come with the description that I've got right here. So this is the front airlock, and yeah, so this is the front airlock where you can come in. Nice, lovely airlock mesh there. I really like that round mesh. It sort of gives all this industrial vibe. And then over here, these guys, these shelves actually are terminals, so you can manage your inventory and all that. And then you've got player skin changey things here. And yeah, so that's the airlocks. Once you're inside the ship, well, you notice right now it's pretty damn beautiful. So, but if I were to go over here, then right here we have the bathrooms. And it does come with autosave, by the way, which is really really meh feature, I think. It depends on what you want to do with the world. Now, if you don't want to fly the ship around, just enjoy it, then it's a great feature because you get to save your progress. But if you want to crash it, then it can be really inconvenient. This is the bathroom. Those are the showers back here. These are the sinks. There's the toilet right there. Two toilets. And it's just absolutely, it's so well laid out, this ship. I really have to give the mod author props for laying this out so well. So here we've got, looks like, yeah, it's basically another place where you can change your skin. A little bit of a med bay going on there. reactor fuel, some more shelf/terminals, and then down here is the long-range scanner/cargo hold, it looks like. So I'm actually going off the images right here, which are really helpful. So this dude right here is your long-range scanner, and then back here would be your long-range scanning equipment. And this is all custom, by the way, obviously. Just a little warning, this is a ship for powerful computers. Recording right now, I'm on Bandicam, and Bandicam has very little frame rate impact, and I'm getting about 26 frames a second. Definitely playable, however, I am on a beast of a computer, so if you got a mid to low range PC, then I definitely would not suggest trying to run this map until you get your hardware upgrade just a little bit. I'll put my PC specs up on screen so you can see exactly what I'm dealing with. Worse frame rate than Assassin's Creed 4 Black Flag, as a matter of fact. And by the way, I may run over time just a little bit, but, you know, I don't really particularly care. What was this? I've never been down that hallway before. I was exploring the ship just to get my bearings beforehand, and I'd never been down that hallway. So, back here, it looks like this is an AI core. I guess you can interact with the AI core, and it looks very sci-fi and high-tech and just gorgeous. All of this ship is insanely cool looking. That's the timer, but I'm going to continue reviewing. That's just a general frame rate, or time frame that I try to hold myself to is 5 minutes. Hi, Hal. How are you doing? I just now noticed you. You are scary. You always have been, and you always will be. Don't try to take over the ship and destroy everything, please. That would be nice. Anyway, so yeah, this is a terminal, as you can see, and you can control all of the stuff here, including the Rupokons. So yeah. By the way, the guy who made this is Russian, so there's that. In case you're wondering why he has Rupokons, this appears to be some sort of loungy thing. Yeah, this is the captain's quarters. In fact, very nice looking. Almost a little Mass Effect-y the way you have to come around. You've got this little area to the right-hand side, and you have to come around to the left, and then there's your bed. It's kind of reminds me of Mass Effect there in a way, and you've got your weight bench so you can work out, your locker, and this terminal here. And if we were to go back over here, you've got your shower and your toilet and your sink and your info terminal. So very luxurious. Splish splash, I'm taking a bath in space engineers. Yeah, very, very luxurious, big captain's area, and here you can look at stuff about the ship. That's actually a screenshot of a rain meter desktop, I shit you not, but it still looks really damn cool. I've got most of these rain meter skins here, but yeah, it still looks really awesome. And if you want, you can lay your desktop out just like that. So you can, it can be as immersive as possible. And yeah, so we're gonna get ourselves out of here now, and we're going to go explore the rest of the ship. The rest of the ship is insanely awesome. I think you guys will be glad to hear. This is actually sort of the main way you get around the ship here. If you were to go straight ahead here, you've got another med pack area, another place to change your suit, and this is actually the reactor core. So very, very nice and noisy as all get out, but still very, very nice. And here's where you would go to manage the reactors and make sure they all stay online and don't blow up. So this is the engineering bay, basically. Tally would be sitting right about here if this is Mass Effect. So yeah, pretty awesome stuff indeed. I love the way that that this reactor core is actually sort of, it's like inside the ship. It's basically within the core of the ship. A little bit forward for comfort if you're in a battle, but I mean, you know, it's very well protected and guarded and everything. So, I mean, if you get out of line of fire quickly enough, you shouldn't run into any power problems. It actually produces, I think it produces way enough power for the rest of the ship. So we're gonna go ahead and we're going to verify that for a second. It's V. Okay, so yeah, 11.67. Yeah, it definitely produces way enough power for the rest of the ship. So if you lose one or two reactors, that would be just fine, as long as you, like I said, got turned around in time. And in talking without looking where I was going, I've completely lost myself. This is the this is the med bay here. So not very big, only two beds. But yeah, you got your medical room there. And patient waiting. No, this is actually the main hall. What am I talking about? I'm talking up my butt. Speaking of which, I think if you go back here. No. Never mind. I was trying to. Oh, yeah, this is the way you get to the mess. So, this is the mess, right? Well, first of all, I'd like to point out that these arcade machines are really awesome. You got Mortal Kombat 2, Space Invaders, Pac-Man, and two more Mortal Kombat 2 cabinets. Go down here, and what is this? Oh yeah, this is a thing. I think that's a gravity generator, and you got your gravity generators right here. So yeah, that's where they are, in case you're wondering, in case one of them becomes broken. So this is the mess right here. Very huge counter space, plenty of space to cook all the food for your crew, and a conveyor right here. That's handy, so you can just open up the conveyor and you can basically just grab your food right there and store it in your fridges. And very, very awesome indeed. And yeah, this is a very, very slickly well laid out ship. I mean, I'm not having any trouble getting around at all. And this is only my second time exploring the ship. The first time, I'll admit, it wasn't very in depth. And then here are the bunks. And you can see they're very, very comfortable indeed. They've got the TV, the pull-out thing. I assume that's where your DVD player would go. Huge amounts of detail in these mods, and therefore in this ship. Absolutely, absolutely fantastically amazing ship, I have to say. That's the bunks again. But yeah, we are back out into the main hallway. I really love this is the thing that I like most about this. I really love how everything's sort of straight hallways, and then they branch off to the sides of the hallways, and then you've got this connecting all the various levels. Very simple to get around. And they're more awesome but pointless terminals. Fridge. Sure. Oh! Wow, space coffee. I didn't notice this when I was first running through here. And then this is your elevator shaft, so you can just sort of boop right up, and then you can get your space coffee and maybe grab a banana from the fridge, and it would be very, very awesome indeed. And then over here is the main control area. And then over here would be the CIC/war room. And yeah, just as you can see, very, very awesome. Very well laid out ship. I really love this ship. I mean, I've played with other ships before, but I mean, this is by far the best laid out. And then up here, of course, you've got more CIC stuff, basically some passenger seats, and then your forward visibility deck. And so yeah, the crow's nest basically up here, and then down there the main control area. And you've even got some space coffee up here. So if you're just piloting through the sector, and you know, you got your inertia dampeners off and everything's going fine, hunky-dory, you can just go over here, grab a cup of Joe, and then sit right back down and continue watching your porn over the extranet. Very, very awesome indeed. And for the record, these displays are just about the most sci-fi awesome thing ever created by man. I love them. That's why I have them as a separate mod. So that's this ship. Done and done. I probably took too long to review this. I mean, way too long, like 10 minutes, but I mean, just this entire thing, it had to be going over with a fine-tooth comb, because it's a fantastic ship. It really, really is. And I think this is going to be the sort of the what does Ectosage call his little station things that he has hanging out in the background, the Sage stations or whatever he calls them. This is going to be what you see hanging out in the background of my videos from now on, because not only is it the first ship I've reviewed, but holy crap in a handbasket is it awesome. And by the way, awesome skybox. It's the Mars skybox, I believe. And I could be wrong, but looks like it's had some serious crap done to it. I don't know. That could just be what Mars looks like. But anyway, so finally we get to these guys over here. These two fighter dudes here. And this guy is the FDGF Dragonfly fighter by Dark Lord Mass. Neat, limber, 41,936 kilograms acceleration, 10.41 meters to the second squared, which applies to both forward and side thrust. And what that does is it opens up a whole realm of combat opportunities, because it more so encourages strafing than than typical, like, dogfighting as we know it, because then you can sort of circle strafe enemies and just be a general headache, as well as having plenty of maneuverability up, down, left, right, forwards and backwards. So there is that. So if you take this guy out for a fly in the middle of a dogfight, you are going to be slippery as all crap. And it's got 43 small containers for all of your cargo and one connector. In fact, the description says the Dragonfly was developed to be a strafing fighter. Hold on, I've got to reset my timer. So, the Dragonfly was developed to be a side strafing fighter, allowing a kind of dogfighting tactic that differs from the typical forward and maneuverability focuses common in atmospheric fighters, therefore has equal acceleration both forward and on the sides. Its relatively heavy armament of 6 autocannons help it to chew apart enemy fighters, as well as do some damage to larger targets like that guy over there, but I would not ever touch that thing because it's too beautifully awesome. And note, he has added a switch to turn the front autocannons, the two closest to the cockpit, on and off. So, because if you're strafing sideways over 68 meters a second, you'll need to turn them off to avoid self-damage. The other 4 can remain on, and I have not found any other self-inflicted damage performing any other maneuver. So, we're going to check out the acceleration on this bad boy. As you can see, absolutely ridiculous. And man, the maneuverability is something to behold. Yeah, I think this is pretty much pointer accurate. I mean, I'm not going to lie, there's a little bit of delay, starting and stopping, a little bit of acceleration here and there, but look at this. I think we can just about fly okay, yeah, as you can see, very maneuverable, very quick to turn and everything. It stops on a dang dime, too. I mean, this is just very, very maneuverable. Okay, so, as you can see, 6 autocannons, and yeah, it's just ridiculous. So, what we're going to do, we're going to try to target this guy, the Norgil. Don't worry yet. Well, Yeah, we're going to go ahead and try to tear this guy apart. Don't worry, that one's a blueprint, so we shouldn't run into any mod reviewing issues down the road. Oh, crap, that's loud. I had to turn that way down because that is amazingly loud. I did not expect the auto cannon that loud. But as you can see, it is just, yep, there we go. Within about, 30 seconds, guys, done and roasted. So just a few good shots and bang, just done. Just done, man, just done. All right, so that is the FDGF Dragonfly Fighter, all reviewed. By the way, just a side note, I really love the way this thing looks. It looks almost just like that. Like, you could park that in one of the hangar bays there and, you know, fly out. You know, people would think it came with that ship over there. It's ridiculous how similar these things look for different mod authors. And as you can see, they even use the same thrusters from Ecto Sage. Yeah, just these are smaller and those are larger over there, so, just great looking ship. And finally, we have the Norgil Light Fighter. And as you can see, it's pretty much exploration mode ready. In fact, I think that was the main intention of this, to go and get the exploration mode. So it uses all default blocks, so there's not going to be any mods on this bad boy. So, yeah, but that's, it looks really awesome for something that uses just all the default stuff. And as you can see, it is armed to the teeth. Look at this. It's got, how many turrets is that? 2, 4, 6 turrets. I believe that, yeah, that's 6 turrets. 2 missile launchers on the side. That's 10 turrets. That is 10 turrets. And, yeah, there's unfortunately no rearward-facing armament, so if some dude decides to catch you from behind, then you are pretty much screwed. And, as you can see, it's got a refueling connector on the bottom, so it's also survival-ready. And we're going to check this guy's firepower out and see if he can get the other guy and serve him a good one. Yeah, guns, please. You aren't working. Rocket launcher 2 is not working, so it seems that everything is all broken. Well, yeah, that just about sucks. But yeah, just as I was going to wrap up reviewing this, my time is expired. So, yeah, it's a really good-looking ship. Unfortunately, it does seem like you'll have to play around with the controls a little bit in order to get it to actually fire. But hey, it's a decent looking ship. It's got a lot of firepower and it's survival ready, so there you go. It's not bad, not bad at all. So now we get into the actual mod stuff, and as you can see, as you can see now, I'm wearing a completely different scary-ass looking skin. This is the Warrant Assassin skin by Tartaross, who apparently makes a bunch of other awesome looking stuff according to his description here. And yeah, I just look absolutely evil. I look like an assassin. This is a good looking sort of skin. It reminds me of something, I think. Once again, something from Mass Effect. Everything in science fiction looks like something from Mass Effect to me, but this looks like Shepard's casual leather jacket that he can wear. What with the leather sort of appearance and the red outlines and everything. And yeah, I look pretty evil. I look like a dude you do not want to mess with. And it's really, really, really very nice. So I can go up, I can grab my weapon. Once I grab it out of the inventory, and then I can go, sup, bitch, da 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 da. And nobody would think it was atypical because I look like this. So yeah, awesome, awesome looking skin. And now you will have probably noticed at the top of the screen that I've got a GPS and waypoint system. So I'm gonna show you guys that now. This mod tracks your position in the world. I'm reading the description. GPS and waypoints by Tyrsis, T-Y-R-S-I-S. This mod tracks your position in the world and gives you your coordinates depending on your position. So this is especially helpful now that we've got exploration and everything. So you won't ever get lost. The coordinates are displayed at the top of the screen, as you see. The mod also allows you to add personal waypoints based on the coordinates you have displayed at the top. These waypoints are only viewable by yourself and are displayed on your HUD as well as in space by a glowing orb. Note, and this is a big issue, please do not stop a ship right on a waypoint and then save or exit. Because when the game's reloaded, basically that glowing orb that marks the waypoint, it becomes physical for a second. It has collision there for a second, and then the game says, oh wait, this shouldn't have collision, and it deactivates collision. But by that point, any ships you park inside the waypoint sort of glowing orb thing will unfortunately have been damaged or destroyed. So yeah, if you want to put a ship near a waypoint, then that's the thing to do. Put near the waypoint. Don't put it in the waypoint. So in order to add a waypoint, the simplest method here. You open up chat slash type slash WP add. We'll just call it, I don't know, waypoint of Cronus. And then it will have created a waypoint of Cronus. So no matter where we go in the universe, we'll always know where our waypoint of Cronus is. And if you want to add it a little bit farther away, you can also do that by typing enter slash WP add name and then text on HUD. So for name, we're going to just call it, waypoint of Cronus. No, let's just call it name for now. And then the text on the HUD, let's just call it negative 506. I'm just thinking of, you know what? I'll just put it up on the screen for now because it's a little bit more involved. And there are also a couple of other commands that I'll also put up on the screen right now, so you can go and look at those. But basically you get the gist of it. It's something that allows you to track where you are in the universe no matter exactly where you are. Basically all the commands do the exact same thing, except you can also add hostile waypoints as well. So if you want to say, over here be bad guys, you would type slash WP add hostile quotes, in quotes, hostile target, and then out of quotes, enemy 10,000 space 0 space 0, this which would add a red enemy at waypoint 10,000 space 0 space 0. And slash WP add currently adds a waypoint at your current location. So basically, just what we did over there, just another way to do it. And for the last and final mod, it's actually not in this world. It's in a completely different world entirely. So I'm gonna go load that up and I'll be right back with you guys. And we are back, and yeah, we're floating above a planet. This is weird. This is space engineers. What is going on? Actually, it's not a planet. It is, well, it's a flat square of stuff, but they call it Planet Christmas. And for the record, no, I have absolutely no freaking idea how in the world they did this. Look at this, man. Look at this. Is this armor? Is this actual snow? How in the world did they make this? This has got to be the craziest stuff I've ever seen in space engineers. This is ridiculous. So, yeah. So, it's absolutely vast and massive, and technically it's a station, but it's a station that simulates plant surface, and yeah, and it's got an awesome little house to go into Santa's own workshop, I presume. And yeah, let's just approach this from ground level. I can't believe I just said that in space engineers. Ground level. Yeah. The sound that your boots make is a little bit weird. But, what is that over there? I'm sorry, this is actually the first time I've ever explored this, so please, forgive me. I simply didn't have time to go and explore beforehand. This is a thing. You're rolling. There's a beeping noise. Are you following me? What is this? What is life? Okay, so you're following me. That's creepy. Okay, you stay over there. Good red ball of death. Yeah, so this is the house itself. And are these actual doors? Holy crap, they slide open. Oh man. This is my house. This is officially my house. Look at the size of this Christmas tree. It's absolutely huge. And it's got presents. What are these? What? They are actually terminals. What even? Christmas tree terminals. Yay! So, I'm now a little stuck. Jetpack, maybe you can help me out here, bruh. Yep, so there you go. Please don't fall back in there. And if we go off over here, oh, this is the dining hall. Santa's own dining hall with a functioning fireplace. Yeah, they mentioned something about this in the description. Yeah, it's an actual functioning fireplace in space engineers. We've also got plates and tables and other awesome stuff. If we go down here, we have, well, this is actually wood. That's cool. So that is amazingly awesome that this is wood. So what do we have if we go all the way down here, down this long staircase? Oh, this is apparently where they make all the presents and stuff. This is cool. Yeah, I can definitely get into this. What was that? I've never heard that noise in Space Engineers before. That is a thing that's happening. You are a bucket going through a portal. And yeah, you're going to be filled with presents or coal or something. What's happening? What was that? I'm actually sort of freaked out right now. What is going on? Is that actually making something? Is something actually being made? Oh my god! This is amazing. This is so awesome. What do you have? You have... you've actually got an object in you. What is that? That is... That's a gift box! That's a gift box. It's got a tag on it and everything. Holy crap, dude. Unfortunately, I knocked it down through the thing, but that's cool. That is seriously A-okay awesome. So this is where they wrap gifts. That is one of the coolest things I've ever seen in a sandbox video game. It literally actually wraps gifts. It literally wraps gifts. There comes a green one. Wow. So wait, are you the dude we just knocked down? That is cool. That is legit cool. That is seriously awesome. This actually wraps gifts. This actually wraps gifts. There comes another one. Wow. Never thought I'd see that. I thought this would just be a bunch of static stuff. But apparently not. Apparently they actually wrap gifts here. Mega awesome. So if we go over here to the left side of the entrance, we have books and reading areas and a library and all this awesomeness. I wonder where Santa lives though, because this doesn't seem very living friendly so far. Oh, this is an observation deck. So that's actually a really cool view, and you've got your Christmas rovers there. So that's awesome. Gravity is just gentle enough so that I can actually jump over railings, which is really convenient. So these guys are gonna slide out of the way. And jetpack one. I remember seeing something. Yeah, this is something over here. Looks like a little undergroundy thing. So more. We are falling in slow motion. So this is looks like a little undergroundy thing. We've got our little rovers here. And this is a med bay. Okay, so this is just in case you die, this is where you respawn. So I think that's all of it. Dude, like holy crap, man. This is insane. This is absolutely one of the coolest things I've ever seen in Space Engineers. So this is fantastic, absolutely fantastic. So just first of all, the aesthetic, all the custom stuff that went into it, the custom meshes, the freaking Christmas tree, and holy crap, the surprise downstairs where they wrap freaking gifts. Absolutely incredible. Oh, it's even got a TV, that's what I thought that was. And over here you've got billiards table, bar stools, and a little place to sit around the fire. That is amazing. This entire place is just fantastic. I can see exactly why it's one of the top rated mods for this week, because quite simply it's one of the coolest, one of the few, but also one of the coolest house mods ever created for Space Engineers. And that this is just legitimately awesome. So I wonder if these staircases lead down to the exact same place. What is this? You are a terminal, so... Oh, yeah. Just so you can control all of your stuff. All of the factory stuff. All of the factory stuff. As in where they make presents. Yeah. So that's exactly where this leads on to. Holy crap, jeepers creepers, that is awesome. So before we go, we're going to take a look at just exactly what goes into this dude. If I can. Oh yeah, there's even a way in here, so just open up. So it pulls back and it's got all that manufacturing stuff there, all those welders and stuff, and they pull stuff through conveyor pipes back there and through that conveyor system into the welders to be welded into a gift. So here we go, we can actually watch it happen. There it goes. And then their well-being, finding a way and constructing it. So they can actually ship it out as a flame for a gift, and then that gives the stuff an actual purpose. So, but they've become blueprints now. I'm sorry I don't understand how any of this works. Oh yeah, they become blueprints when they're ready to... they just become blueprints so that the game knows what to do. And then the frame for the gift box drops down. And then... bang, there we go. Onto the conveyor system. It then gets held in place, or at least sort of twists into place by that landing gear there. Passes by these three welders here that progressively weld it into shape as a gift box. So there we go, step one complete. And then drops under this guy, let's see what happens. It's a conveyor system, I guess that's where they put the presents in. So yeah, we're gonna follow this dude. And it's made a sound. That's a... literally, okay, so it actually drops a teddy bear into the gift box. That's cool. That is seriously awesome. Unfortunately, this teddy bear is... well, it's mine now. So, yeah. And then it's going to be molded into a gift box. It actually drops a teddy bear. So, these things actually contain stuff. Wow. That is amazing. And then passes by this guy over here. Gets molded into its final shape, into its final form. Yeah, me stealing the teddy bear. I am a greedy Santa. And then, well, we're going to wait on you. Actually, you know what? Let's just go ahead with this guy and see where all these guys end up. So I guess it gets pushed by the previous present and it ends up in here. And then, yeah, so they wait here apparently for the elves to come and retrieve them. And yeah, that's how Christmas works, apparently, in Space Engineers. So this guy's gonna get knocked into place by this present here. Yeah, I believe that's exactly what's gonna happen. And boop! So down the slider he goes, and then, down they both go, apparently, so. Oh, wow. I never thought that this would be this awesome. I just thought, you know, it's a house mod, and the only extraordinary thing it's got a little plant side sort of deal, and yeah, some other stuff going on. I never imagined that it would actually have a gift manufacturing facility. So that's awesome. So I have to say, out of all the mods I reviewed this video, this one has to take the cake. Because not only Christmas, but also just the fact that it can make presents complete with teddy bears. That is amazing. So yeah, this one wins the roundup. And so that has been this video. If you like this video, then go ahead and bits out that like button. If you really, really like it, you want to see more, go ahead and hit that subscribe button. Hey, I've been entertaining. You've been awesome. I'll see you guys in the next video.